好，问大家一个问题。
Let me ask you this.
请问你现在是怎么看你现在的身份？
How do you look at your own identity right now?
比如你出到社会的时候，你怎么看你自己？
When you step out into the society, how do you look at yourself?
OK, 要你想比较困难的。
OK, I know it's hard for you to answer this open-ended
question. 所以我给你选择题。
That's why you're given a few choices.
好 ，A 是贫贱的人士。
A, poor people.
低下的人士
B, low class people.
C 是普通人士
C, normal people.
D 是中等人士
D, middle class people.
最后是尊贵的人士
Finally, E, distinguished people.
来 A 的请举手
so, Those who think that you're A, please put up your hand.
哇好谦卑很好
so You're so humble, thank God.
然后 B,
What about
B 的请举手
If you think that you're a B, put up your hand please.
哇，也有一个。
Oh, there's one low class people here.
C 的请举手。
C,
哇，大多数人都是 C 的。好 ，D 的请举手。
What about D?
中等啊，我是。有吗
？Anyone?
没有人举手。
No one think that he's a middle class.
来，最后一个尊贵的人士，有没有人敢举手
？Distinguished.
哇，有一个，感谢主。
We have only one. Thank God.
好，请你记得你刚才所举的答案。
Please remember your answer.
因为这将显示出。你的信仰观
For this will actually reveal your value of your faith.
而且它会影响着你的生活
It will also affect your life.
每年的10月31日
Every year, 31st of October.
我们信义会我们都会纪念马丁路德宗教改革的日子
The Lutheran Church commemorates this Luther's Reformation.
所以今天是十月的最后一个礼拜
Today, as it is the last Sunday of October.
我们也是一样纪念这个宗教改革的日子。
So we are also here to remember this day.
什么是宗教改革
？What is Reformation?
就是中世纪罗马天主教他们的腐败。
During Middle Ages, the Roman Catholic churches were so corrupted.
然后就造成了改革运动的这个酝酿。
And that's why it started this movement of Reformation.
然后一直到1517年的时候。
All the way until 1517.
来到马丁路德的时候才改革成功。
Reformation was finally succeeded under the lead of Martin Luther.
所以罗马教会再次的面临分裂。
So Roman Catholic Church was once again being divided.
所以被分裂出来的，你们知道叫什么吗
？You know what is the one which is being which left the Roman Catholic?
是的，就是更正教。
That is a Protestant church.
就我们信义宗跟长老宗，就是宗教改革而开始的。
Lutheran church and also Presbyterian church were then formed.
所以左边的是加尔文。
So this is John Calvin.
所以右边的是马丁路德。
And that is Martin Luther on your right.
所以路德他提出了因信称义的教导。
Martin Luther voiced out the teaching of justification through faith.
然后他也提出了十字架神学。
He also mentioned the theology of cross.
然后他也提出了四个唯独。
He also voiced out the four solas.
就是唯独基督、信心、圣经还有恩典。
Which is Christ alone, faith alone, scripture alone, and grace alone.
当然他还有提出一个。
Of course, he also mentioned another one.
就是信徒皆祭司。
That is priesthood.Of all believers.
所以今天我们就来认识什么是信徒皆祭司。
Today, let us learn what does it mean to be priesthood of all believers.
首先，我们来回顾历史一下。
First of all, let us take a look at the history.
因为祭司这个身份被掳掠了。
Now, priesthood has been taken away.
他怎么被掳掠的呢？
How did this happen?
是在什么时候信徒皆祭司的这个祭司的身份不见了
Now, since when this priesthood concept of everyone was taken and disappeared?
所以我们先来了解祭司是什么
First of all, let us understand, what does it mean priesthood?
祭司从什么时候开始的
Since when priesthood began?
啊？旧约开始的，对
In the Old Testament, yes, you're right.
就在摩西的时代上上帝就是颁布十诫给以色列人。
During the time of Moses, God gave Ten Commandments to the Israelites.
然后他教导以色列人怎么敬拜上帝。
God also taught the Israelites how to worship Him.
所以就上帝就指示摩西你要怎么建造会幕。
And God also taught Moses how to build the tabernacle.
然后造了会幕需要有人来负责安排敬拜的事项。
Once the tabernacle was built, we needed people to serve inside the tabernacle.
所以就需要有祭司来做。
And that's why priests were needed.
所以上帝就安排叫 摩西就安排了祭司来侍奉上帝。
So God instructed Moses to arrange priests to come and serve.
所以在出埃及记十九章四到六节这边讲到。
Exodus chapter 19 verse 4 to verse 6.
上帝就对摩西说：“我向埃及人所行的事，你们都看见了，且看见我如鹰将你们背在翅膀上带来归我。”
You yourselves have seen what I did to Egypt, and how I carried you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself.
如今你们若实在听从我的话，遵守我的约，就要在万民中做属我的子民，因为全地都是我的。
Now, if you obey me fully and keep my covenant, then out of all nations, you will be my treasured possession.
你们要归我做祭司的国度，为圣洁的国民，这些话你要告诉以色列人。
Although the whole earth is mine, you will be for me a kingdom, a priest, and a holy nation. These are the words you are to speak to the Israelites.
所以上帝就选了利未支派来负责这敬拜的职责。
And so God chose a tribe of Levi to take care of this serving.
然后由利未支派中的亚伦家族来担任大祭司和祭司的这个职分。
Out from the tribe of Levite, the descendants of Aaron were to be the priest and also the chief priest.
不过是有条件的。
However, under one condition,
就是做祭司的他必须身体是健全的。
Which means a priest has to be healthy in his body.
而且外貌是端正的。
And his face must look appropriate.
如果你容衰就不能了。
If you don't look appropriate, then you can't be a priest.
所以身体有病的，样子很奇怪，你是没有资格来做祭司的。
Those who are ill and also don't really look good, then I'm so sorry, you can't be a priest.
而且祭司是带着生命危险来侍奉上帝的。
And every time a priest served, he was actually risking his own life.
因为每次献祭的时候，祭司他必须保持自己身体的洁净。
For every time when a priest served, he had to make sure that his body was really cleansed.
免得他在献祭的时候被上帝发现他还有罪，他就会被杀死。
Or else, if he was found guilty before the Lord while he was serving, then he would be struck by the Lord.
因为上帝是圣洁的。
For God is holy.
他绝不容忍罪在他面前。
He would not endure sin before him.
所以侍奉上帝是一件很神圣的事情。
Therefore, it is something very holy to serve the Lord.
而祭司是圣职。
And priesthood is a holy position.
是上帝亲自任命的。
It was chosen by God.
而不是谁说哦，我要做就可以做。
It's not something that you do because you want to do it.
所以今天我们有在教会侍奉的。
So those who are serving at the church today.
不要以为哦，我只是一个伴唱而已。
Don't think that oh, I'm only a backup singer.
不要以为哦，我只是一个招待而已。
Don't think that I'm only a small usher.
不管我们在教会参与什么侍奉。
Regardless of what position you're taking at the church.
都是尊贵的
All are holy.
都是圣职
All are noble.
所以好不好告诉隔壁的
So let us say to one another.
侍奉上帝是一件神圣的事情
Serving God is a holy matter.
来告诉隔壁的
holy matter.
侍奉上帝是一件神圣的事情
Let's say to one another.
所以来到耶稣的时代
When it came to the time of Jesus.
祭司的制度就被更新了
Now the priesthood.The system of priesthood had been renewed.
因为有一位大祭司出来了。
For there was a great priest now.
是谁呢？
Who was that chief great priest?
谁呢？就是耶稣了。
It was Jesus himself.
是他是大祭司。
He was a great priest.
他也成了那个赎罪祭的那个祭物。
He himself had become the sacrifice also.
就为我们献上给上帝。
And he offered himself to God for us.
所以因着耶稣基督他在十字架的救恩。
Due to the salvation that had completed by Lord Jesus on the cross.
圣殿至圣所的幔子就裂开了。
The veil in the holy temple was broken into two.
所以从此以后人不需要再透过祭司来见上帝。
Ever since, and men do not need to come to God through a priest.
每个人都借着耶稣基督的宝血，能够来到上帝的面前，与他面对面。
Everyone can come before the Lord face to face through the blood of Jesus Christ.
而同时，我们每个人也因着这样，被上帝赋予了我们有祭司的身份。
And at the same time, everyone is given this beautiful and holy.Identity as a priest.
所以刚才我读的经文
The scripture that I read just now.
经文说我们是被拣选的一族
The scripture says that we are a chosen race.
是君尊的祭司
We are a royal priesthood.
而且是一个圣洁的国度
And also a holy nation.
是属上帝的子民
We are God's people.
所以接下来我要用一些图画来让大家能够明白
Next, I'm going to show some illustrations to help you understand better.
我们的祭司的身份是怎样慢慢被淡化的？
Now, how does this priesthood identity was gradually taken away?
初期教会
early churches,
信徒的人数他们不断的增加
as a number of Christians add, were increased continually,
下面就是有很多的信徒慢慢一直在增加
from this picture, many, many believers coming to the church.
然后他们就开始凡物共用
So they started to share everything in common.
大家的东西大家都可以用。
So, all possessions were shared by everyone.
然后由于使徒们他们过于忙碌
Since the apostles were too busy,
然后就忽略了一些寡妇
They neglected the needs of some widows.
然后没有分派到日常用品给他们
These widows were not given their daily necessities.
就有人发声了，就吵了
So some people voiced out.
所以他们就选了几个执事啊
And that's why. How many deacons were chosen?
几个
？How many？
有上查经的。
Those who attended the
七个，对了，他们就选了七个执事。
Seven deacons were chosen.
来关心这些弱势的群体。
To take care of those minorities.
来管理这些行政的事务。
And also to take care of the administrative.
然后使徒们他们就能够专心的传道。
So that the apostle could focus on spreading the gospel.
如果有上查经班的弟兄姐妹，我们查考《使徒行传》的，你就。非常清楚。
Those who attend our Bible class while we are reading the Acts, then you can understand this very clearly.
其实保罗他就开始去欧洲，就是布道了。
Apostle Paul began to travel to Europe to share the gospel.
他走到哪里就在哪里建立教会。
Whenever he went to a place, he started a church there.
然后他就设立了监督或长老来管理教会。
He also established elders or bishops to take care of that church.
如果那个地方的基督徒是以犹太人为主的
Now, if that church were, mainly Jews,
那个领袖就叫做长老
then the leader would be called as an elder.
如果那个地方是以他们的基督徒是以希罗文化为主的
If the Christians there were mostly, Hellenistic believers, Hellenistic influenced people,
那你的领袖就叫做监督
their leader would be called a bishop.
所以长老跟监督是一样的。
At first, a bishop and an elder were the same.
都是教会的领袖。
They were both the leaders of the church.
就好像现在的牧师一样。
Just like our pastor of modern day.
但是虽然教会有领袖
，Though there were leaders at the church,
也有信徒。
There were also lay leaders, lay believers.
但是大家都不分高低的。
Everyone was equal.
大家都是全民皆兵的。
Everyone was soldiers of God.
每个人都。齐心的侍奉上帝。
Everyone served the Lord in one heart.
所以在保罗在哥林多前书也强调，教会是基督的身体。
And that's why in 1 Corinthians, Paul also emphasized that the church is the body of Christ.
每个基督徒都是这个身体 的肢体一部分。
Every Christian is part of this body.
所以有不同的颜色。
That's why you can see different colors here.
不同的颜色就代表着什么呢
？What does it mean?
就是像。以弗所书四章十一到十二节所说的
，Just like what is mentioned in Ephesians chapter four，
圣灵赐的有使徒，有先知，有传福音的，有牧师，有教师，为要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体。
So Christ Himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors and teachers to equip His people for works of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up.
哎，牧师哦
，A pastors。
这个牧师跟现在的牧师一样吗
？The pastors mentioned here are they the same as the modern day pastor？
其实不一样。
Not really。
这里所提到的牧师
，pastors mentioned in the scripture，
他就好像一个牧羊人一样
，refer to someone like a shepherd，
特别是在关怀上
，especially someone who takes care of others，
在辅导上特别有恩赐的人
，someone who's gifted in counseling others。
所以他们是负责做关心的。
So they take care of how to care for others.
看到有谁需要安慰的，他们就去做。
They would comfort those who needed.
所以有需要有扶持的，他们就去做。
They would go and help those who needed.
所以你可以看到，那大家都是五彩缤纷的。
That's why you could see they're colorful people here.
因为大家都按照自己的职分、自己的恩赐去侍奉上帝。
For everyone served the Lord with his own gift.
所以这就是活出了人人皆祭司的这个生命。
You know, the early church, they really lived out the life of priesthoods of all believers.
但来到主后一百年
And yet, when it came to AD 100,
使徒们都回天家了。
When all the apostles have rest in peace,
彼得保罗也不在了。
And Peter and Paul were also not there.
活到最老的门徒是谁啊
Even the oldest disciple John，
那约翰也走了。
John he was also gone。
所以那时教会的组织就开始有了变化。
And so the structure of the church was changing。
为了要稳固教会
，in order to consolidate the church，
能够为了要更有效的抵挡异端
，in order to resist the cult more effectively。
所以个人的领导的权力就越来越大了。
That's why personal individual power and authority got bigger。
原本的监督和长老是同样的，就平等的。
Bishops and elders they were on the same status。
后来监督就高于长老了。
Later on, bishops became a little bit higher than an elder。
然后后来监督就变成主教了。
And later on, bishop became cardinal。
当然，主教后来也变成教皇了。
And cardinal became the pope。
所以教会的组织就越来越复杂了。
So the hierarchy and also the structure of the church became more complex。
然后你可以看到
，and you could see
信徒他们的恩赐的这个侍奉的这个机会就被淡化掉了。
The chances of believers serving the Lord are now getting less and less。
而越来越受限制。
They were more limited。
来到第三世纪的时候
，when it came to the third century。
基督教变成罗马的国教。
When Christianity became the national religion of Rome，
然后教会的架构就照着这个罗马帝国的官僚体系来制定。
And when the system and structure of a church became something like the bureaucratic system of Rome，
所以一层一层的金字塔的架构就走出来了。
There was formed this Catholic church hierarchy，
所以就有平信徒啊，最低的。
That's why you have at the layer at the lowest bottom there. There was this lay people.
然后就有修士了。
And then we also have this nuns.
就有神父了。
And also priests.
就有主教了。
And cardinals.
就有区主教了。
And also bishops.
然后红衣主教，然后中主教，然后到教皇了。
Archbishops, cardinals, all the way up to the pope.
所以当时教会的架构就出现了两个层面。
And you could see there were the people that time they were separated into two categories.
一种就是圣品人员。
One were the one who served the Lord.
一种就是平信徒。
One was a secular people.
平信徒 lay people.
The lay people.
所以平信徒就是这些蓝色的最低的那一部分。
So the blue one you can see the bottom layer. Those are the lay people.
所以第二个层面就是红色以上的就是圣品人员。
From red to the top, those are the holy people.
什么是圣品人员？
What does it mean, the clergyman?
就是修士，他们就是修士以上的，包括神父啊、主教这些，就是他们放下工作、放下家人，进到修道院里面。
Clergyman refers to someone who let go of his own life, his own career, and he went into a monastery.
然后他们开始修炼
，and he started to meditate.
然后一层一层爬上去
，so layer by layer they would climb up the ladder of this hierarchy.
啊，他们进入修道院，就好像我们华人的出家这样。
When they went into a monastery, just like the Chinese people went to the temple.
因此他们也不结婚的。
That's why they also didn't get married.
所以他们是一生专心要侍奉上帝。
They wanted to serve the Lord throughout the whole life.
所以他们与世隔绝。
So they were separated from the secular world.
他们才是属灵的。
Then only they are the holy people.
他们才有配得去侍奉上帝。
That's why they are qualified to serve the Lord.
所以他们才有资格担任教会里面的圣职。
And that's why they have the qualification to take the position of a church.
所以教会从此就演变成被神职人员垄断的一个机构。
Ever since then, the church became an institution that were monopolized by all these clergymen.
所以信徒
，So lay believers，
你有机会侍奉上帝吗
？Did you have a chance to serve？
没有。
No。
不要说侍奉。
Don't talk about to serve the Lord。
平信徒连读圣经都没有资格。
Lay leaders didn't even have the chance。To read the Bible.
为什么
？Why?
因为怕你乱曲解圣经。
Because it's afraid that you would distort and misunderstand the Bible.
所以圣经是由圣职人员来替你读。
Bible can only be read by the clergyman.
然后读给你听。
You can only listen.
信徒你听就好了。
So lay believers, you just listen.
祷告呢？
What about praying?
祷告你也不用祷。
Now you cannot pray.
所以我们在戏里面常常会看到教堂里面。
That's why in movies you could see in a church.
然后有一个告解室。
You can see a confession room.
然后有人就进去。
Someone would go inside a confession room.
神父，我有罪啊。
Father, I have sinned.
所以他就为你祷告。
And that father would pray for you.
然后领圣餐呢？
And what about Holy Communion?
我们圣餐里有基督的宝血，还有基督的身体。
We have the blood and also the body of Christ.
那平信徒，你没有资格领这个杯。
But lay believers, you had no right to receive the blood of Christ.
因为基督的宝血给着你这属世的人喝。
How can the blood of Christ be given to you, such a secular person?
开玩笑。
Are you kidding?
你吃肉就好了。
You only take the body of Christ.
啊，耶稣的宝血。耶稣的身体里面肉可能还有带有 一点血
Maybe the body still has some blood in it.
所以他们怎么吃饼呢
And how did they receive this body of Christ?
饼呢就是你连动都不能够动
Now you can't even touch it with your hands.
因为你的手啊沾染过世俗的这些污秽
For your hands are dirty.
至少碰过钱肮脏了
Because you have touched money, that's why your hands are filthy.
你要领饼怎么领呢
If you want to receive the body of Christ, how do you receive it?
口张开，神父放下去。
Open up your mouth, the pastor, the father would put the body of Christ on your tongue.
所以你今天去天主教
，Today, if you're to attend a Holy Catholic church,
他们还是这样的。
They are still doing this.
然后你只能够吃饼
，You could only take the body of Christ.
杯你没有份
，You don't have any part in the blood of Christ.
神父替你喝
，The father would drink it for you.
所以耶稣本来他。借着他的救恩，他把祭司的职分赐给每一个信徒。
Originally, through the blood of Jesus Christ, God gave the priesthood to everyone.
但罗马教会却把这个信徒的身份掳掠了过来。
And yet, Roman Catholic Church snatched away this identity of priesthood.
所以怎么办
？What should we do？
所以来到马丁路德的时候
，When it came to the time of Martin Luther，
他就在威登堡大教堂的门口贴了这。95条的论纲。
He nailed this 95 theses on the big gate of Wittenberg Church.
然后后来他也提出了信徒皆祭司。
Later on, he also mentioned priesthood of all believers.
他就对这些教廷说。
And he said this to all the popes and cardinals.
教廷把教皇、主教、神父称为属灵的位阶。
You know the church. You call those cardinals and fathers, all the clergymen, as the holy people.
君王、贵族、工匠或农民，则是属世的位阶。
And you call the kings, the noble ones, the carpenters and the peasants as the secular people.
你哋冚唪讲大话。
This is a lie.
因为路德他自己有机会看圣经。
For Luther, he had the chance to read the Bible.
他知道圣经告诉我们，我们每个人都是。尊贵的祭司。
He knew very well that the Bible teaches us that everyone is a priest.
所以他就强调信徒皆祭司。
And that's why he emphasized on priesthood of all believers.
然后把侍奉的权柄还给每一个基督徒。
And he fought for this. He wanted the right of serving to be given back to all believers.
因为他要让大家知道，侍奉不只是圣品人员才有资格的。
He wanted everyone to know that it's not limited to the clergyman only to serve.
只要你相信耶稣，你就有资格侍奉上帝。
You have the right to serve the Lord as long as you believe in God.
然后他也强调因信称义。
He also emphasized on justification by faith.
然后把信仰还给基督徒。
And he wanted this religion and this faith to be given back to Christians.
因为信仰信心。不是靠功德而得来的
For faith is not gained through work.
而是因着信心相信上帝而得的
Faith is gained when you have this trust in the Lord.
所以他也强调唯独圣经
He also emphasized on sola scriptura, only the scripture.
把圣经还给我们
Please give us back our Bible.
上帝的话是基督徒生命唯一的准则
The word of God is the only standard of all Christians' life.
不是教皇说了就算
We do not just listen to the Pope.
所以从1517年到现在
And therefore from year 1517 until now,
你要感谢上帝因为你有圣经可以读
We have to thank the Lord for we can read the Bible.
不然的话还是神父帮你读
Or else you still can only listen to what the Pope tells you.
所以我们看了信徒皆祭司整个的历史进程
Now we have looked at the very quick development of how thispriesthood of all believers.
我们要来想想看，哎，有什么可以提醒我们的
？So let us ask ourselves, What are the things that we are reminded of?
那首先
First of all,
我们一定要认清自己是祭司。
We must know clearly that ourselves, we are a priest.
今天我们人怎样衡量或者断定一个人的身份？
Now, how does a man nowadays evaluate another?
你刚才举手的时候，你是以什么标准来举的？
Just now, when you put up your hand, according to what basis you put up your hand?
那可以讲来听听看吗？
Could you please tell
me? 你是以什么标准来举手？刚才我第一个问题的时候。
Based on what standard you put up your hand, you answer my first question just now.
社会阶层啊、哦、原来我们有社会阶层的马来西亚
You look at the society status
还有呢
And what else?
有吗那些贫贱的
Those who think that you are poor people
哦，因为身家啊身家不够多啊
You based it on your own bank account
所以我们通常都是看人的工作
We normally look at someone's career
啊，看他从事什么专业的
We see what kind of profession he's in
然后也看那个人的教育背景
We also look at his education background
哇，是硕士啊还是博士啊
Is it a master? Is it a PhD?
啊，然后他看他是收看他的收入
We must also look at his income
哇，月入三万
Wow, 30,000 every month
不错不错
Not bad
啊，然后就看外在的穿着
And we look atHow he dress up?
啊，看他驾的车。
The cars that he drives.
看他住的房子。
The house that he lives in.
通常人都是用这些来断定一个人的价值和身份。
Normally, this is how we evaluate a person and how we value someone.
但基督徒是不是这样看
？And yet, should we Christians also do the same?
基督徒绝对不是这样看。
No, this is not the way we're supposed to do.
我们只有一个标准。
We have only one standard.
就是单单看你是上帝的儿女来断定你的价值。
That is, your value is being decided by whether you are a child of God.
这上帝的儿女代表什么呢
？What does it mean to be children of God?
就是尊贵的身份。
It means that you have a noble identity.
荣耀的身份。
You have a glorious identity.
大能者的身份。
You have this almighty identity.
因为你有全能的上帝。是你的帮助。
For the Almighty Father is your help.
还有祭司的身份。
You also have this identity as a priest.
今天许多人受到世界的影响。
Many people are being influenced by the secular world nowadays.
我们把社会的阶层带进教会里面。
We brought in this secular hierarchy of the society into our church.
认为教会也是像世界一样，也是金字塔架构。
We think that our church is also like the same pyramid structure.
因为教会有牧师吗
Because we have the pastor.
有会度吗
We have bishop.
哇，越来越高的
And then all the way up.
那我只是一个普通的平信徒
And I'm just a lay believer.
所以今天借着信徒接祭司的教导
Hopefully today through the teaching of priesthood of all believers.
你一定要认清自己是祭司的身份
We must understand one thing clearly that we all are priests.
如果你脑袋现在都还有平信徒这三个字的。
If you still have this word in your mind, lay believer,
今天你一定要 delete 掉它。
Please delete it from now on.
原因第一。
First reason,
圣经从来没有提过平信徒这三个字。
Never has the Bible even once mentioned the word lay believers.
都是用信徒或者主的门徒来称呼所有相信耶稣的人。
The Bible only calls those who believe in Jesus as信徒 believers and also the disciples of the Lord.
然后第二
Secondly,
平信徒这三个字是罗马教会腐败的时候所产生出来的。
The word, the term lay believer is actually a product of this corrupted Roman Catholic Church.
完全不符合圣经的真理。
It doesn't go with the truth of the Bible.
所以所有相信耶稣的人
That's why those who believe in Christ,
不管你是会度牧师长老或者刚信受洗的初信徒
Be it you are a bishop, you're an elder, you're a pastor, or even you're just a new baptized believer
大家在主里都是
In Christ,
一家人
We're all one family
所以我们都称大家是什么
And that's why we call one another as
弟兄姐妹对吗
Brothers and sisters
有没有人很少人称先生，你是小姐的是吧？哦，老板啊。
Sometimes they call someone boss.
有没有人
Just joking.
有没有人来到教会？哎，靓仔啊，哎，靓女啊。
Do you call beautiful guy or a handsome guy or beautiful girl at the church?
我们都称弟兄姐妹。
We call each other as brothers and sisters.
虽然我们有牧师、有族长、有领袖
，though we have pastors, we have cell leaders, we have leaders，
这些都是上帝给他们不同的恩赐，在不同的职分上。
Now these people they serve because God has given them different gifts to serve。
我们应当尊重他们。
We must respect them。
但对于身份，每一个人都是一样的。
However, when you talk about identity, everyone is the same。
没有人比任何人高。
No one is higher than another。
因为大家都是上帝的儿女
For we are all children of God.
所以明白了自己祭司的身份
Now, once you are clear with your own identity as a priest,
你要知道你有祭司的权柄
You must know that you have the authority of a priest.
什么是祭司的权柄
Now, what is the authority of a priest?
刚才我说了祭司是做什么的
So what did I say just now? What does the priest do?
啊献祭了，对吗
？To offer sacrifice，
为百姓向上帝献祭了。
You offer sacrifice for the people，
所以你是有权柄的。
You have the authority。
有些基督徒以为
，Some Christians they think，
哎呀，有一些事我们一定要找牧师来为我祷告啊。
You know I really must go and see a pastor and ask him to pray for me。
因为牧师的功力比较高深。
Well, a pastor is more powerful。
啊，弟兄姐妹
，So dear brothers and sisters，
如果你要找功力、武功高强的人
，If you want to find someone who has a higher or a more Greater功夫，
你应该去神庙找。
You should go to the temple.
教会没有。
You can't see anyone like this in the church.
教会没有所谓的高人或者大师。
We don't have master in our church.
最多最多，我们有特别恩赐或者比较有经验的牧者而已。
We only have some pastors or someone who are more experienced.
因为上帝。我们的祷告，上帝垂不垂听
？Now, does God listen to our prayer?
病得不得医治
？Or whether an illness is being healed?
秘诀在哪里
？Now, what's the secret to it?
秘诀就在于你是否诚心吗
？The key is whether you are sincere enough.
你是否有信心吗
？Whether you have faith enough.
你是否有一个圣洁的生命吗
？Whether you have a holy life.
然后最后要看上帝愿不愿意。
And finally, it depends on whether God is willing or not.
所以这些就是秘诀。
So these are all the keys.
所以不要以为哦，这边是白色的牧师啊，就 power 很大了。
Because he has a white collar here, that's why he has greater power.
如果那个牧师随随便便为你祷告
，If that pastor simply prays for you,
你也不要想上帝会成就。
So don't expect that God will answer your prayer.
上帝是看内心的。
God looks at our inner heart.
所以如果是90岁没有读过书的婆婆为你祷告。
If an old lady, 90-year-old, he has never gone to a school and she prays for you.
有可能神迹发生吗
？Do you think that a miracle would happen?
有可能吗
？Is it possible?
有。
Yes, it is.
如果3岁的小朋友为你祷告
，If a 3-year-old child prays for you,
两句罢了。
She only uses 2 sentences.
祷告有可能成就吗
？Is it possible to be answered?
有。
Yes, it is.
因为大家都是祭司。
For everyone is a priest.
所以我们一定要记得这一点。
We have to remember this.
所以再次提醒你隔壁的。
So once again, remind one another.
你是祭司，告诉他。
You are a priest.
啊，第二。
Secondly.
就是我们要预备好自己侍奉上帝。
We have to prepare ourselves to serve the Lord.
过去我们都谈论过。如何善用我们的恩赐去侍奉上帝
？In the past, we have talked about how to utilize our own talent to serve the Lord.
但我们有预备好自己吗
？But my question is, are we prepared?
有些基督徒我们知道啊、哦，我们知道上帝给我什么恩赐。
Some Christians they know very well what kind of gift God has given them.
他也知道他要怎么去侍奉上帝。
He also knows very well how to serve the Lord.
那是因着某种的因素。
And yet, due to some reasons,
可能是人际关系的问题。
Maybe because of relationship with others.
可能是家庭的问题。
Maybe because of family issues.
可能是工作的问题。
Or maybe your work problem.
可能是自己的生命出现了一些状况。
Maybe something happened in your own life.
令到他不。去不敢也不能去侍奉上帝
causing this person to dare not and would not and cannot serve the Lord
这样就浪费了上帝给我们的恩赐和机会
what a waste of talent and chance
彼得前书4:10-11
First Peter chapter 4 here it says
这边讲到个人要照所得的恩赐彼此服侍做神百般恩赐的好管家若有讲道的要按着神的圣言讲若有服侍人的要按着神所赐的能力服侍，叫神在凡事上因耶稣基督得荣耀。原来荣耀全能都是他的，直到永永远远。阿门。
Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. If anyone speaks, they should do so as one who speaks the very words of God. If anyone serves, they should do so with the strength God provides, so that in all things God may be praised through Jesus Christ. To him be the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen.
弟兄姐妹，
so dear brothers and sisters,
恶者会用不同的手段来阻止我们去侍奉上帝。
The devil will use all the tricks to stop us from serving the Lord.
所以我们要很小心。
Therefore, we have to be very alert.
要很谨慎。
We have to be very cautious.
因为侍奉上帝是什么？
For remember to serve the Lord
是一件什么事情？
What kind of matter it is?
啊，忘记了。
You've forgotten.
是。神圣的事情
to serve the Lord is a holy matter.
是圣职
It is a holy position.
虽然所有基督徒都是祭司
Though all Christians are priests.
但是上帝绝对不会随随便便让人来侍奉他
God will never just simply let anyone to serve him.
他也不会让那些随随便便的人来侍奉他
God would also not let someone who simply to come and serve him.
还记得上帝对祭司的要求吗
You remember what are the standards God has towards the people who serve him.
身体有问题，容衰的也不能够来侍奉上帝。
If you're unhealthy, if you don't look good, you can't serve.
所以祭司的服装，上帝跟摩西说，你要怎样制定，然后叫他们穿。
God even gave a dress code to Moses.
然后要献什么？要怎么献？
What kind of things you should offer and how do you do it?
通通上帝规定好。
Everything was well clearly instructed by God.
为什么敬拜上帝、服侍上帝是那么严谨的？
Why is it such a sober and very serious matter to serve?
因为上帝是圣洁的。
For God is holy.
他是荣耀，他是尊贵的。
God is glory, God is splendid.
反观今天我们来到神的面前。
However, today as we come before God,
我们有带着最好的生命、最好的精神、最好的心态、最好的装扮，献上最好的祭给那最荣耀的上帝吗
？Do we come before the Lord and offer to Him our best life, best form, best attitude, even best attire, and also our best sacrifice?
今天你上班的时候，你会穿短裤拖鞋去见老板吗
？Would you wear T-shirt and short pants to go and see your boss?
今天你在婚礼上，你会献唱一首完全没有排练过的歌吗
？Would you perform a song at a friend's wedding without rehearsal？
在那些场合，我们都不敢这么做。
No, we dare not to do such a thing at those occasions.
让我们想一下，我们来朝见荣耀的上帝，虽然你看不到他，
Then let us ask
但是他就是在。
When we come to serve our Lord, though we can't see Him, and yet He is present.
我们是带着什么的态度、生命？来朝见上帝。
With what attitude, with what life do we come before Him and see Him?
请问这是什么东西
？Let me ask you, what is this?
啊？啊
？What is this?
垃圾桶。
You say it's a dustbin.
这个是空的。
Now this is an empty pail.
这个是桶啊。
It's a pail.
如果你放水，它就变什么？
If you put water in it, it becomes a water pail.
放米就变什么
？If you put rice in it, it becomes a rice pail.
放酒就变。
If you put wine in it, it becomes a wine barrel.
当然，放垃圾就变。
If you put garbage in it, it becomes a dustbin.
我们基督徒每一个基督徒都像这个桶一样。
Every Christian is just like this pail.
那不是讲你是饭桶。
I'm not saying that you're a 饭桶。
我们都好像一个桶。
We all are just like a pail.
我们里面装什么，我们就是什么。
Now, you are what you contain.
今天我们每个人都是祭司。
Everyone is a priest.
但是我们里面的生命是装着什么东西
yet, ？What is contained in our life?
我们是装着上帝的话吗
？Do we contain God's word?
我们是装着圣灵所结的果子吗
？Do we contain the fruit of Holy Spirit?
我们是装着祷告吗
？Do we contain the prayer?
还是装着许多不属于神的这些垃圾
？Are we filled with all kinds of filthy things that doesn't please God?
所以当上帝要来看到这个桶的时候
，When God comes and look at the pail，
满堆垃圾
，A lot of garbage。
你觉得上帝要吗
？You think God wants it？
啊
？Do you think God wants it？
送给你要吗？
You want
你也不要
？Do you want it？ You don't even want it。
所以我们连我们都不要，更何况是上帝
？If we don't want it， what would God do？
所以盼望每个星期，或者是每一天，
really、
我们都要我们里面的装的都是。属于上帝的东西。
Every day, every week, things that are filled in our heart are things that are pleasing unto the eyes of God.
因为上帝不要里面有污秽的人来朝见他。
God doesn't want those who are filled with filthy things to come and worship Him.
所以求主帮助我们。
May the Lord help us.
预备好我们自己的生命。
Let us prepare our own life.
来侍奉伟大的上帝。
To serve our great God.
所以500年前宗教改革完成了吗
？500 years ago, this Reformation happened. Now, was it completed?
完成了吗
？Has it completed?
还没有哦
Not yet, right?
对啦
You're right, not
就像孙中山所说的
Just like Dr. Sun Yat-sen has said that
革命尚未成功同志仍需努力
Reformation is not completed yet Comrades, let's continue to work hard
所以我们要努力什么
What shall we work hard for?
我们要不断努力用上帝的话来改革我们的生命
We have to let the word of God come and renew and reform our heart
改革那些我们在信仰上框起来的那种框框
Reform all those old boxes that we've got
这样我们才不会走向罗马教会的那条路
So that we won't become like another Roman Catholic Church
就好像我们国家这样
Just like our country
如果西蒙不痛定思痛的话
Now if Pakatan Harapan they don't just repent and do good things
他就会 走回谁的路
They would become just like
走回他后面那个国政的路咯
You could see that. BN.
所以求主提醒我们
May the Lord remind us.
在教会里面身份没有分高低
No, there's no one higher than anyone else in the church.
只有职份上的不同
We only have different positions.
因为我们都是圣徒
For we all are believers.
我们都有祭司的身份
We all have this priesthood.
也有祭司的权柄
We also have the authority of a priest.
所以只要活出合乎上帝心意的生命
As long as we live our life that's pleasing unto the eyes of God
我们的侍奉我们的祷告都是有功效的
Then our service our prayer will have effect
因为上帝没有把他的子民是圣跟俗分出来的
God didn't separate us as secular people or holy people
他也没有把我们周日和周末的生活分出来
Neither did God separate our Sundays from other days
因为每一位是信徒
Everyone is a believer
每一天都应该过着分别为圣的生活
Every day we should live a set apart day
因此我们礼拜天去教会
Therefore, when we go to the church on Sundays
我们是一个聚集的教会
This is a church that gathers everyone
所以星期一到星期六你进入你的生活
From Monday to Saturday, you go on your own individual life.
我们是被差遣的教会。
We are a church that are being sent.
每次我们要领受祝福之前
，You know, every time before we receive our benediction,
我们都会宣告一件事。
We would proclaim one thing.
你记得是什么吗
？You remember what is it?
我们奉主的名出去，然后我们怎么回应
？So we go out in the name of the Lord, and how do we respond to that?
上帝已经恩待我们，让我们去侍奉他。
Because God has been so gracious to us, we will serve Him.
去哪里侍奉他
？Where do we serve the Lord？
已经出去了哦。
You go out.
就去你的合场，去你的职场，去你的学校，去你的家庭，去你的社会侍奉他。
You go out to your workplace, to your church, to your society, to your community, to your school to serve Him.
所以我们预备好了吗
？Are we ready？
求主帮助我们能够活出合他心意的样式。
May the Lord help us to live a life that's pleasing to Him.
因此
，Therefore，
我们必须为着自己能够侍奉上帝而感到非常的荣幸。Amen.
We must feel very honored as we are given the chance to serve the Lord. Amen.
所以我们非常要珍惜，要认真的看待每一次侍奉的机会。
So we have to take every chance to serve as a precious one.
所以求主帮助我们。
May the Lord help us.
我们同心祷告。
Let us pray in one heart.